Well, today we're on the border esk. It's a stretch I've fished quite a lot over the years. The water's getting lower. It's had rain, but the colour's dropping out of it now, so it's probably going to be hard work today. There has been a few salmon caught in the beats adjoining to this stretch, so there is a chance of a spring fish or a spring salmon or a sea trout, probably larger sea trout as well this time of year. Anyway, we'll get you back on when we get to the river. Dippers there. Oh no, wagtails. Wagtails on the river. Big rear wagtails, I would think. So this is called the Chapel Pool. That's the Chapel Run. I had a salmon off here a couple of seasons ago. And that building at the bottom is called the old water pump house. Obviously turned into a residence now. Looks like there's a bit of a fly hatch, so we might see some salmon power and smolts rising. I like yesterday, I think I'm gonna set up with a small stork's tail, and we've got a chance of a sea trout. Oh, the salmon. Get set up. Let's see how we do. important to fish right into the very neck of the pool. Sometimes fish have almost got their heads outside the pool, so they're very top of the water. Amazing, that. It's amazing where you can pick fish up, so you've got to start right at the top. So it's like two separate runs with a dead part in the middle. And the difficult part is going to be covering that far run without getting an early bath. Pushing through a bit here. Covered that nicely. Felt soles on these waders, which grip the bowls a little bit better. think this bit is probably the best part of the pool. This is where I hooked a salmon a few years ago, but very difficult to fish because this flow coming down the middle. I wanted to fish the outside crease, the line between the flow and the dead water. And the problem is it keeps picking the fly line up. So I'm constantly having to work to keep the fly over there. See now, you see it bending in the fly line and bringing it back over to the middle, which is a bit earlier than I wanted. But it's not an exact science. Sometimes the salmon will pick up as it does just what you don't want it to do. This is Gilnockie Tower, right at the side of the river. As it says, the ancestral home of the Armstrong clan. That must be the Armstrong crest, I would think. Around here. We always come to fish the river, we never look down the tower. Well, that's the back side of the tower. Fishing up if it's raining. sometimes get ospreys over here. Yes, it's lovely country even if you're not fishing. This is for the cold pool, called, which is I think Scottish for weir. The weir right at the bottom, you could see right at the bottom being concrete lit. And it's a lovely pool further down. This is just a run in. I've had fish on the spinner and the worm in this pool in the previous year, in past years. Glad the sun's got in for 10 minutes. I've got different waders on now. These have got rubber soles on, so not quite as grippy as the felt ones. I think I've got a little salmon par or smolt. Yes, a little smolt, look at it. Yeah. Yeah, little baby salmon. So we're ready to go to sea. Well, going to be a long walk to the car with my waders like this. I don't have much luck with waders. That's about the third time this has happened to me over the last 7 or 8 years. I'm lucky to get 2 seasons out of a boot. Anyway, luckily I've got a spare pair in the car. Always be prepared. Well, this is the short home pool. Well, we're getting towards the end of the day today. Maybe another hour, fish this pool down. Then it'll be back to the accommodation. The fuel beers. Using a little shrimp fly now, tiny little shrimp fly. A lot of the colour's gone out of it, dropped quite dramatically. Nice little bit of flow out with this run into the main pool, so should fish okay.